Hi everyone, this is Jeanette, and thank you for joining me for another card making episode. It's Halloween night and everybody's out trick-or-treating but me, and so I'm up in my craft room just kind of puttering around. I wanted to show you a little card that I made earlier in this week. I had actually made this card for the Gypsy challenge that was held around the 25th or so. It was a 24-hour challenge, and I never completed it in time to submit it as an entry. So I just went ahead and finished it the next day, and this is the card that I came up with. You had a few rules that you had to follow. One of them was that you had to use your Gypsy in order to create your project. You had 24 hours in which to complete it in, and you had to use the two cartridges that were preloaded on the Gypsy, which is the Gypsy Wanderings and the Gypsy font. And then you could use a third cartridge of your choice, which I chose to use Winter Woodland for my third cartridge. And I'm going to go through the steps and show you how I did this card. My card base is a 5x7 card base that is purchased from Walmart in the package of cards. It's in the crafting section. And I went ahead and cut my pattern paper, which is a snowflake paper. I cut it at 4 7/8 by 6 7/8 and adhered it to the white of the card, the white card base. Then on this tag that the Let It Snow is on, this came off of my Gypsy, and let me see if I could get this to zoom in. This came off of my Gypsy, and it is this part right here, and that actually came off of my Gypsy font cart, and it is this monogram button, the shift lock, and it is this little icon that's down here in the corner, and I cut that at 3 1/4 by 3 inches. And actually what I did was I did this initial one here at 3 1/4, and then using my advanced features I went ahead and just hit it, and then I copied it, drug it off to the side, and then just using these arrows here I downsized it until until it fit inside this one here that I wanted it to fit in. And then I went ahead and drug it off to the side and for my other base. This is the white base part of it. Let me go ahead and do that one, get rid of that one. So I went ahead and layered the Let It Snow together, the two pieces. And then I went ahead and I put stickles around the outside of the tag that was sticking out from the center part. Then I cut this little portion right here, which is right here on my mat. I cut that using my Gypsy Wanderings. And that is, I think it's right here. It's right here. It's on the last icon, and just that one is lit, and then it's the second one from the bottom, and that gave me this right here. And I went ahead and enlarged it, and then I cut that using my Gypsy. Then for my little snowman, I used my Winter Woodland cartridge, and I used this little one for my little gentleman. He is on page 46 of the book, and I cut him at 4 inches, and I cut him out again using the layers button for his little scarf, and using the shift key of the snowman himself for his little hat and the scarf. And then this part here gave me the little intricate cut that has the little squares on it. And then I went ahead and put those together. I decided to use little black beads for his eyes, and then little bling for his buttons. For the little girl, she is on page 47, and I cut her at 4 inches also, using the same keys that were appropriate for her. I cut her. Then I went ahead and cut her hat and her muffler and her heart, and then using the layers key, I cut this portion of her little scarf, and went ahead and layered them all together. and put her heart on, and then I took just a little pen, and I went around the pen in pink just to give it a little more definition, put some little white lines on her hat, and added a little bit of bling to her scarf, and then added little eyelashes. This little thing is some little bling that I got at Michael's last weekend. They were in the dollar bin, so I added that to the front. On this little tag here that I cut with the Gypsy font, I went ahead and embossed it using my Swiss dots, but I turned it over so the deboss side was facing out, and then just put a little bit of color in the little indentations. I threaded some ribbon through that, and I actually layered it on a piece of white ribbon, even though you can barely see that on the bottom here, and went ahead and attached that to my card. And then I added some bling for the center of that little piece. The Let It Snow portion of this came from Winter Woodland, and it is towards the back of the book on page, let me see real quickly. It's kind of hard to work around the video camera here. I'm afraid I'm going to knock it over, so I'm trying to be extra careful. So I'm going to probably go off camera here for just 1 second so I can find that. It's in the book before the house part. It's right here. It's coming up right here. It is this part right here, this Let It Snow. And I went ahead and just cut the Let It Snow part. And I cut it out of the same pattern paper that I used for the background, and then I just inked around it. And I think I cut that at about an inch. And went ahead and inked around that and added it to the sign. And then with this little snowman, blingy snowman, there were little snowflakes on there, and I just added that to the top of the card. And this would have been my entry for the Gypsy Challenge. I like the way it turned out. It took me 2 hours to do, and I really didn't finish it in order to enter it in the challenge, but I'm happy with the way that it came out. And I hope you enjoy this card too. Here's hoping everybody is having a safe, happy Halloween. And thank you for joining me this evening, and I'll see you on my next video. Thanks a lot. Bye.